Did you know that there's many little ailments that can be eased with just simple food items that you have in your kitchen? If you have a sort of well-stocked fridge or pantry, chances are that you're going to have lemon, celery, apple, garlic, sometimes parsley. You may also have some dry apricots or ginger even, or blueberry. So I'm just going to show you some little tricks here. We're going to start with the upper body, so you can think headache. You know, if you have a headache and you're feeling like extremely hot and you're like excess heat, we could call it maybe a hangover or any type of headache that feels like it's an excess. You would really do well on celery. You can, if you have a juicer, if you're lucky enough to have a juicer at home and use it, you can make celery juice with lemon juice. Those two to get together has a cooling effect, and it will reduce the inflammation in your body as well if you have got arthritis or any inflamed tissues in the body. So this is a very good trick, and before reaching for the Tylenol or any over-the-counter drug. This is a very classic one, the garlic oil for earache. You can use in children, and some adults have earache sometimes too. Crush up 4 or 5 cloves of garlic in about 3 ounces of olive oil, and you let it infuse for 3 days, just at room temperature. And after 3 days, you strain it and put it in a dropper. And all you need, you can heat up the bottle in warm water so it doesn't, you know, if your ear is very sensitive already with the earache. So just one drop will be enough. As for prevention of earache, or even when you have an acute earache, parsley. If you want to eat the parsley, I would say 2-3 ounces a day. You can just chop it, and when your food is ready, you sprinkle over it. And if you make a tea, parsley tea, use about like 1/4 cup of fresh parsley. You can drink 2-3 cups of parsley tea a day. If you have a painful dry sore throat and like a dry cough, I would recommend apricots that are unsulfured. So that's why they're brown, as opposed to the one that you sulfur, they would be golden. So those are the natural one. And if you have fresh apricots, of course, you could use them. So I would say you can eat 2 or 3 dry apricot every morning and every night. That will help easing the dry cough, the dry throat, and the excess mucus. Grated apple, it's actually very good, especially if you have lots of heat, you're feeling hot, and this will cool you down and will help to resolve the mucus on the lungs. For the common cold or any sore throat, or you're coming down with a chill, this is something I like to keep on hand in my fridge all year round. This is very simple. It's grated ginger with honey and a little bit of water, and you just reduce it until it becomes a nice golden paste. You can use it in cooking as well, and or as a tea. You use about 1 teaspoon in a cup of hot water and sip that slowly, and you'll warm up instantly. This is also good to ease a sore throat. And for a cough, I like to use the blueberry syrup. This is made with vodka or gin, sugar, and blueberry. And you cook it, you strain it, and you have this beautiful purple syrup that will ease any cough. And as well, for a sore throat, that is, you have difficulty swallowing, I like to use the kombu. I do soak the kombu in warm water for about 20 minutes and drink that water, or you can make a tea. You could add it with this ginger tea. You crack a little piece of kombu, add it in your tea. It won't change the taste very much, and it's not going to be salty, don't worry, but this will give a nice cooling effect to your throat. That's going to help to ease it. Now if we go to lower body, for stomach ache, stomach ulcer, stomach heat, you know, it's burning, you had a spicy meal, cabbage juice works wonderful. If you don't have a juicer, it's fine. You just chop very finely some raw cabbage, green, red, doesn't matter, just the nicest, freshest cabbage would work. Jams can be very healing. This is a blueberry jam. Any digestive system complaints, like such as diarrhea, the blueberry is very astringent. It's nice when you have children and they have diarrhea and you give them blueberry jam. They think that, wow, this is wonderful, you know, like it's comforting for for people as well to have something that will heal them, that they know it's food, it's not something foreign like a medicine, you know, that can be used. You can be a bit scared, like, am I going to have any side effects? And well, this is food, you won't have. And this is a rhubarb that does the opposite. So when you stock them in your pantry, make sure that you know what they're good for. So the rhubarb would be for constipation. So this is good in the spring when the fresh rhubarb is out. Make sure you make some jam and save some for the year ahead. One thing that is good with asparagus, and I like to use them, is for bladder infection. This is very nice. This is straight into the kidneys. This is a food for the kidneys and bladder. So eat as many asparagus as you can when you have as the first sign of the infection, and that will help to clear away. And same as, I'm sure you've heard of the cranberry juice but I find that the cranberry juice can be irritating. Carrots, it's one of my favorite. It keeps your skin just healthy and beautiful. We all know that carrots are good for night vision, but carrot is also good for any wounds that you have, any burn. If you burn yourself in the kitchen, if you don't have a juicer, again, you can just grate the carrots and put some grated carrots on the burn, and it will soothe it right away and help to heal properly. Any scratches, any burn wounds, carrot is one of my favorites. So carrot, think skin and carrot is good. For easing bruises and strains, a nice hot bath with bay leaves will help reduce the pain and the bruising. So again, this is all ingredients that you can find very easily at the store, or you may have them already in your kitchen. So another one that might not be, this is not difficult to find in any natural food store. This is the kombu seaweed. I use it for recovery because this is so full of minerals. It will enhance the flavor of other foods and help to assimilate. So when you're recovering, you want to eat things that are easy to digest, like soup. But I like to do the congee. So congee, this is a traditional soup. It's used mostly in Asian kitchen. There's many different flavors of congee, but you can make a basic one using water, grains, and let it cook for 3 or 4 hours until the rice or the grain is overcooked and the water is thick. So you can use different flavorings. I like to use kombu because kombu is very rich in minerals, and when you're recovering, you need the minerals to heal your body. You can add ginger if you have a stomach ache or you feel nauseous. Instead of using water, you can use chicken stock, beef stock. That will give it more strength as well. So congee is one of my favorite food for recovering, and I think everyone love it. You can flavor it as you want. And you'll see the recipe on the website, and I'll show you different ways to do it. I think that with those few items that we looked at today, this might give you a bit of confidence to the next time that you feel a bit on the downside, to reach for your cupboards or your fridge and see what you have fresh.